I've never had to do anything like this in my life. I'm not that close with Buddy's parents, and I can only imagine that they're going to be completely devastated. Like, ignorance is bliss. Maybe they would have rather not known that Buddy has a drug problem.
Hey.
Hey, can I come in?
Sure, come on, Ace. Good to see you.
Good to see you, how are you?
Fine, how are you doing?
Good, hey, Elle. Hey, girl. Hey, Luby, how are you?
Hey, good.
Oh, you want something to drink? It's hot out there.
Sure, please.
Yeah, come on. What would you like?
Oh, water's fine.
Well, come on, have a seat.
Even though it's probably gonna be the most uncomfortable conversation of my life, I have to do something proactive to feel like I'm doing right by him. And this could be the end of my relationship with Buddy. Maybe it will be. But I won't have to go to bed at night knowing that I had a friend in trouble and I didn't help him.
So what's up? I was gonna call you actually this weekend.
I'm just here because I'm really worried. Basically, Zach told me that Buddy has a pretty significant drug problem.
We know.
You know.
We know, and I'm so sorry. We just found out. Philip actually came and told us.
So Phil knows.
Phil knows.
Phil is Buddy's brother who lives in DC, and I had no idea that he already knew what was going on with Buddy, but I am so grateful that he told his parents. I mean, it's a relief.
Philip said, I have something to tell you. He said, it's not good news. And I said, oh, you're scaring me. And he said, you should be scared. And I just lost my mind at that point. I just knew it was Buddy. I didn't know what, but I knew it was Buddy. And he said that he has a significant cocaine problem. What?
Where is Buddy now?
We confronted Buddy. He's in treatment.
I feel like I let him down somehow. How didn't I know? Am I a bad friend? Why didn't I try harder to figure out what was going on? It's like I'm living in the same house with him. And I should have been able to help him, and I couldn't.
When we confronted him, he did not want to go to treatment. He just said, I know that I need help with this. He said, but I'm going to do it myself. I can do it myself.
No.
He was hurt because we gave him some tough choices, like, you can't come over here. We'll go meet you somewhere to sit.
Like, if you don't go to treatment,
he have a meal with you.
Turn your phone off.
You know.
He pays for the phone, but it comes to us, so we just cut it off. And so finally he said to us, well, you're going to leave me to die on the street, so I'll go. And so.
Oh, God.
Basically, he said that he didn't have a choice.
He didn't have a choice, yeah.
Right.
Just the thought of bringing him into this facility, he doesn't know anybody there, and he's going to be in detox for 2 days by himself. It just hurt me as a mother because once he got there, I didn't want him to feel alone or scared.
Yeah.
As a parent, you just naturally want to take whatever pain and take it on yourself. Don't mess with my kids.
Very hard to leave him there. So. My heart just breaks that's where he is right now.
I don't know if she has any tears left. I'm telling you, it's been rough.
It's been hard to work. It's been hard to do anything.
And so where is he then? He's not here.
He's about 3.5 hours away.
How does that work? I mean, he's an adult, so he can just leave if he wants to, right?
He can leave, yeah.
So there's no guarantee he's gonna even?
No. No, and that's another thing to worry about.
So he can just, like, walk, he can just sign himself out?
He can just sign himself out, and that's primarily the reason he's not in treatment here in Greensboro, because we're afraid that anybody
could go. It would be too easy.
A visitor could go, say, come on, let's go.
I mean, to know that Buddy's situation is so fragile is completely terrifying. How long does he stay there?
6 weeks.
6 weeks.
So what can we visit him?
We don't know just yet.
God, I don't know what Heather's gonna be. Do I just tell her?
Just tell her.
Just tell her, okay.
It'll help for
It'll
things
help
to make sense to
yeah.
her.
Yeah.
I mean, like it did with us.
Yeah.
This is going to kill Heather. It's gonna kill her that she didn't know. It's gonna kill her that she couldn't help him. I just wanna just tell him, I mean, if you can tell him before I can talk to him, if you can just tell him that I love him and that I'm sorry that I didn't know or that I couldn't support him, just please tell him that I love him so
absolutely
much.
Absolutely tell him that.
And I'm just really sorry.
And when we find out everything, you know, what the allowances are, you know, we'll be in contact.
Okay. Finding out that Buddy has a cocaine problem is the missing piece to a puzzle that I have been trying to put together for months. It makes sense about where his money went. It makes sense about why he sleeps all the time. And that's also why he was kind of erratic with Heather and broke up with her out of the blue and kept talking about some elusive problem he needed to fix, but he couldn't tell us what.
Thanks for being a good friend.
Now we need to redirect. Instead of what's wrong with Buddy, it's gonna be how are we helping Buddy? What are we doing to support Buddy? And we're gonna have to start looking to the future to when we get Buddy back. And I don't know if we're gonna get Buddy back. I hope we are. I wanna get Buddy back.
Be careful.